Hello everyone, welcome to a video showing how to start in naval action. Today with Matty Mowers.
Hey guys.
And with me we'll be showing you how to start in the game. The start is very simple. First thing you want to do is go to the ships in the top section. You want to choose the 7th rate and take the basic cutter that's free. Okay, I'm not able to buy as I'm having full docks, so I just need to jump into a ship and try to buy it again. Okay, now it works, but you won't have that problem. So, once you have a basic cutter, you have already equipped base medium cannons, and you have no money to buy different guns for your ship and coronets as well. So first you want to do some missions to actually earn money, and to do missions you go to the missions tab. You want to choose between order and fleet order, and I really recommend doing fleet orders. So first order is midshipman, and that's one you should choose in the beginning. We'll take three of them, which is maximum. And by pressing M we can view the map, and these missions will spawn next to your capital. For the British nation, capital is Kingston, Port Royal. So right now what you need to do is also manage crew and hire the full crew for your basic cutter, and the 40 crew members you can get for basic cutter is free. Okay, that's everything for now. Once you will get money also, you will want to hire an officer. Right now I'll reset my officer. Not reset, I will dismiss him. And by clicking hire officer, it costs 1000 gold. I'm going to hire a new officer, there we go. And I'll just level up him with the missions and battles and such stuff. So it's also good to play this game with other people, like Matty Mowers for example. And
yep.
You need friends, it's very helpful. And if you have any friends in that game, you want to invite them to the group. So just right click on the friend list, group invite, and have them in the group. Okay, let's set sail. Oh, I forgot about the repair kits. Here you can buy repair kits, they're also free, so you can buy all of them. Let's set sail! We are entering the open world. There we are. And soon we'll be able to see the first mission. The closest one probably will be this or this.
Okay, so lead the way.
Okay, just follow me. You can see that funny red and white flag above group members. You can also see other players that are sailing in open world. You should pay attention to every ship around you, just to make sure you will not run into enemy fleet. But most likely when you're in a basic cutter they will not try to attack you. Okay, these cross swords show us the place where's the mission you're heading to. You might also see some battles and epic events with the same symbol, and the difference is that they are called Admiralty Orders. Okay, it's a little bit against the wind. In the bottom section you can see the shallows, and you can get stuck in the shallows. In open world it's easy to get out of them, but you should pay attention to it. And we are almost at the mission, marked on the map next to the Carle port. We can see already a port in the distance. Once we are close enough, we can enter as a group, or you can always do the missions alone, but as I said, it's much better to have a comrade doing missions with you. Okay, here you can see we can already enter as a group or alone. If someone is not able to enter from the group, you'll get a warning that not everyone from the group can enter. So by pressing tab, I can view our teammates, our enemies. You can see there are three enemies, one in a snow, pickle and rattlesnake. And we've got one friendly AI on our side, Flora Radish, in a cutter. So just by pressing W, you're just setting sails, raising them. By right clicking on both of the sides, you're overviewing the cannons, preparing for the salve. You can see your crew's loading, so it takes a while in the beginning, but we have enough time to get close to the enemy fleet. Mati is just right behind me, so most likely I will take all of the damage.
Yay! So, which one are we attacking?
Let's go for the one on the left, I would say. In between the left one and the middle one. So we can shoot both of them. There's a pickle and snow. Yeah, you can get a lot of helpful information on the map when you click them up and press that funny box. Okay, cannons ready. Okay, that was not very accurate, to be honest. This one guy is stuck against the wind. And yeah, as you can see, the basic cutters are not very strong. And in the top left corner, you can see the HP of each section, the bow, the rear, the stern, and the two sides of the ship. When you click space, you can single shoot just to see if we are hitting the enemy ship. That's also very helpful. You should also pay attention to the waves, as it's a bit harder to hit when there are big waves.
Oh, we've got visitors. Somebody joined our battle.
Oh, nice. That will be helpful, as we do not have very strong ships. Yeah, two people, the new players from the Zopit clan. One is a lieutenant commander, the second one is second lieutenant commander. No, second commander, yeah? Something like that. So they are new players as well. Yeah, this is how it works. For 2 minutes, the players can join and help you in the mission as reinforcements. By looking at the enemy ship, you can see also their HP and the sides that they have loaded. The ports, the left one, right one shows where they have loaded cannons, so it's very helpful information. Okay, when you're playing with other players, not for example on the TeamSpeak, where you are, you can always use the chat, of course, by pressing T. T? No, it's not T. It's enter. You need to press enter and type something. Okay, I'm a bit heavily damaged. Yeah, these basic cutters are really crappy ships, but yeah, that's the ship you start with. Right now I will attack the wind, so it means I will turn against the wind. That's a bit tricky. Something is wrong. Oh, I have a damaged rudder. Yeah, that's the thing. When you have a damaged rudder, pump, or magazine, you have to press 5 and click the 3, which is urgent repair. And you can use it once every 7 minutes. So use it only when it's needed. This battle is not really fair, as we are against the Snow Pickle and Rattlesnake, which are much better ships than basic cutters. Also, another tip is you want to get as many hits on each of the ship to get at least assists and kills. The more ships you hit, the better it will be. The more experience, the more gold. Oh god, I'm slowly taking water because I have few leaks. But no worries, I have crew on survival. They are fixing the leaks. And as soon as my armor on any of the sides is good enough, I will not have big problems with that. Let's take a look at the map where the enemy ships. There you have one Rattlesnake, one Pickle, and one Snow. Now we'll attack the wind, as I said before. For attacking the wind, you need a speed like at least 5-6 knots. For smaller ships, it can be less, too, because you do not want to get stuck against the wind. For that, you need manual sailing. And that's a bit harder than just normal turning with A and D. Okay, that's quite risky to sail towards these ships, as I don't have much armor left. Hey, Matty, how is it that you have so much armor?
What? Sorry, I've got lags.
Why do you have so much armor and I'm almost dead?
Because I'm smart.
No, you're hiding all the time behind me. You're not playing.
Exactly.
You're not the brave sailor. Okay. And I will hit the stern of that ship. Okay, 3 hull hits the stern. Actually, hitting stern in the missions is not really helpful, but I'm trying to avoid the broadside. Going broadside to broadside with enemy ship to Do not take more damage. Okay. There's a lot of smoke here, so you need to pay a lot of you need to pay attention not to run friendlies. To avoid friendly fire. Oh god, they damaged my pump. I do not like it. Damaging pump is not nice.
Do you have urgent repair?
Nope, I've already used one and I have a cooldown. 3 minutes.
How much? So, goodbye.
No, I'm not sinking.
Yet.
I just follow you. Okay, this guy already used his broadside, so I can save without big problems sail next to him and not take any damage. Okay. Come on. Don't hit me.
Ding 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 ding.
Ding ding. When you press... what button you press actually?
J.
J, okay. When you press J, you can ring, so you inform other ships that you're about to hit them. Explode or warn them that you're close by. J, like jingle. Okay, it would be a nice moment to fix my pump as I have one leak. It would be really nice. I'd actually love to fix my pump. But I still need to wait about 25 seconds.
Maybe hide behind me?
I'm avoiding broadsides. But they're still doing some damage on me. It's not hard to kill the basic cutter. I'm trying to stern camp. So they're not hitting my sides. That's one of the ways of avoiding damage. Right now I'm using the single shots as I'm trying to get a hit on all of them. Okay, I can fix my pump. And I still have a repair of my armor, so that's not bad. Okay, how is it? We still did not sink any of their ship. It will be very hard to kill the rattlesnake and snow. But Our renommee and know from the Zopit clan will be very helpful in that situation. Okay, I'm hitting a little bit too high as I got 3 hits on sails. If you want to remove the effects of waves of healing, you should depower, and that helps really, really helps when you are shooting. To depower, you have to press T. So basically what happens, you hide the stale sails and you heal much, you stop healing that much. Okay, I will go away from that rattlesnake as I don't like it. I will head towards the pickle. Pickle has heavily damaged his left side. Actually, I will have to use my repair, I think so. It's my left side and right side are really heavily damaged. You will see in the top, in the bottom left sector, the level of the water on your ship, together with the wind direction also, which is helpful information. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, only one full hit. Click 5 and 1 to repair the ship. If you need more crew for the repair, you can turn off the gunner by pressing 7. And I hope they will not focus on me, but looks like they're all trying to focus on me. Oh yes, they
I'm
do.
I'm coming to help you.
Oh man, come on. I need to get away a little bit. My dear, they keep hitting me. That's too bad. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Ding, 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 ding.
Ding, ding.
Sorry.
Yeah, I'll be dead. I cannot repair more, I think. I have already too many people on the survival. Wait, if I remove the people from survival, it will start sinking faster, but I can repair it a little bit. No, I have not enough crew. And there we go, I'm dead.
Oh no.
So right now we can see how other people from our team are performing in the battle. Or we can turn on the free mode by pressing home button. So we can fly with a free camera and watch everything. It's a very good thing for recording and for looking at the situation far, far from you. And we've lost our AI. So right now it's 3 versus 3. If you do not want to lose your officer's life and do not lose your crew, you can use the surrender option, and this option is good when you have a ship with a lot of crew and hiring crew costs for bigger ships. Also, you don't want to lose your officers' lives, because to level up your officer it takes a while when you start the game, and the officer is really helpful with his perks. There we can see the Renomy. It's going to hit snow, I believe. Yeah, that looks like a snow. Wasn't a very good hit, but he's a new player as well. Okay, we'll keep watching Matimaris and see how he dies in the clutch.
What?
You're going to be targeted by two.
I'm going to win.
No, you're going to die. You're just a peasant in a basic cutter.
Because you told me to take basic cutter.
Yeah, of course, that's what new players can only afford. That's actually not an acceptable situation where the midshipman mission has snows and rattlesnakes. I remember when I started the game, I was failing almost all of the missions of midshipmen in a basic cutter because they were just too hard. They are very tough. As you can see, Matimaris has damaged his right side. You can zoom in, see. Yeah. There's a visible...
No, I don't. That's not true.
That's a visible damage. So he has to protect his right side. The best thing for him will be to keep facing the enemy ships on the left side. Anyway, you can...
Or just hide behind this guy.
Yeah, that's true. Anyway, you can get your ship penetrated through the whole ship, so you can take damage on both sides, even if the enemy is shooting only on left or right side. The pickle is going to die. It's already sinking because it has already one side damaged to the zero. You can look at that ship, how is it sinking? It's getting much slower. You can see that it's taking water and it's going to die in about, I would say, 10-15 seconds, maybe a bit more. Anyway, if you died in a mission or you surrendered, it's always good to stay in a battle so you can get still more kills and assists even if you are dead, and thanks to that you'll get the more XP and gold after the mission is over. There we go. The brave charge.
Whose charge?
Yours.
Oh, thanks.
Is he going to hit
Oops,
the beach?
I've got 2 leaks.
No worries, mate. 2 leaks is not much. I had like 3 or 4.
I am taking water.
Yeah. Just calm down. You're just next to the island, almost at the beach. You can go sunbathing. Just dock your ship. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
The pickle is dead. You can see. It's absolutely sinking. The sinking animation is not perfect. It doesn't look very well. I hope it will get improved. Oh, he's a little bit stuck. So, where's the second enemy? Oh, he's right here in the snow. You should actually go for the snow, Matty.
Why?
It will be an easier target for you.
But here are our allies.
Yeah. It looks like the snow is going to focus on you.
Just, oh, that's lovely.
Yeah, he's just going directly towards you. And this one got stuck against the wind. He's using manual sailing. You can see he rotated his masts, his sails, in the front and the and at the back, in different sides to use the wind so he can rotate his ship. Beginnings are very hard, but once you can afford a snow or other ship, it will be much easier. The snow is most likely the best option after the basic cutter. Some players also love Mercury, which is the best shallow ship. Or at least it was before the heavy rattlesnake. But Mercury is not a good ship for the new players, that's what I think. Okay,
I'm going to repair myself.
Yeah, that's a good moment for you to
repair. Damn it. They are shooting at me.
Yeah. Yeah, just sharing all the love with you.
That's sweet.
They almost do not care about the enemy and snow, the friendly.
Very funny.
Okay, the snow is almost dead. You have more problems with rattlesnake. Remember that you can surrender before you start sinking, because once you start sinking, you cannot surrender. That's the main thing, the main problem. Okay, the zombie sailor is dropping his sails, waiting for the army. I dismissed my officer, so I have totally new one with the zero level, and Matimaris has still his good officer, so it will be most likely good for him to surrender now. Not yet.
I can still win this.
You will start sinking soon, you will sink faster than the rattlesnake. Are you sinking already?
Nope.
That's weird. Do you have upgrades on your basic cutter?
Nope.
No, it's a good time to say goodbye for the Matimars. There's no way he can survive longer than the rattlesnake.
Oops, I'm sinking. Great.
Yeah, of course you are.
Okay, one last charge.
We are facing much more superior shapes to the basic cutters. You have to turn really hard left if you want anti-power, if you want to shoot. Okay, now turn right.
It's ram time, baby.
You can actually start boarding him, and if you win the boarding, you will not lose your officer.
Wait, that's a great idea.
Yeah, you might have problems starting the boarding, but once you start the boarding, and if you win it...
I do have problems.
You can capture his ship.
Wait, I'm... No, he's boarding me.
Okay, try to brace and defend. Always use defend when he's attacking. And whatever else he's using, just click brace. Do not attack. Just try to survive as long as possible. He's much more crew than you have, that's too bad.
I can make it.
The AI has advantage in boarding, they have some boarding mods. They're absolutely missing the people from our team, but we cannot blame them, they're new players. Anyway, the snow is sinking as well, you will both sink, actually. Are you already full on water?
And I'm dead.
And he's dead as well. Okay, so there are two players, the friendlies. Oh, I did not get any kill and assist. That's too bad. Matimars.
I've got one assist.
Yeah, you lucky bastard.
Pure skills.
No, you just need to kill the last AI ship, and you will get the gold and experience reward for finishing the mission. Let's see how much HP has the rattlesnake. Not much armor left on both sides, and our friendlies are in a good condition. Okay, as you can see, it's really good to have more people doing midshipman mission with you than just one. We've got actually four players, including me, in that mission. AI is very often retarded, they are doing very stupid things, swimming, boarding, the things that players do not like. The snow in the middle is preventing the zombie from shooting his broadside. That's not very good. The snow should turn like now he's doing and get ramped a little bit. Or he should just speed up or slow down. You can see a very smart choice from the zombie sailor. He was using back fire mode, so he started shooting from the back to the front, not like normally the ships are shooting from the front to the back. And they will just finish this rattlesnake soon. I'll probably not get any assist or nor kill, so we can leave now this battle. Once you leave the battle, you'll be in a battle screen. You can see I lost my officer life. Normally officer has 10 lives. I've got a little bit of gold, EXP and officer EXP. I will spawn probably in the nearest city, nearest port, which is Carle, I believe. Yeah, I'm in a Carle. I will dismiss my officer again. And I want the fresh one with the full lives. Let's see if I redeem the EXP. If my officer will get the EXP for that. No, it looks like my officer is not getting the EXP from the redeeming EXP. Oh, he's getting. That's nice. Okay, now let's sail back to the capital, to the KPR in my basic cutter. And this time we'll actually really quickly show you how does the mission look like in a bigger ship, like a snow. Matty, do you have a snow from me?
What? Snow for you?
From me. Did I craft for you one, or did you buy one?
I don't know.
Okay, I can craft one for you. What are you doing?
Teleporting.
You lazy boy. You're just next to the capital and you're teleporting. Come on, man, don't be so lazy.
I will be first in the capital.
Okay, so this will be probably enough for part 1, how to start a naval action. And in a part 2, I will show you, once you finally get the snow, maybe some upgrades and better cannons, I will show you more information what's next. Thanks a lot for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, subscribe. So, see ya!
Bye bye!